Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. How are y'all doing today?
4 years ago, for about $2 million.
I'm going to be gone.
Now, you guys are right about this tonight. I follow my practice. I do this sort of thing because I am constantly notified by the residents of Kinsey Park here to our left that I specifically have too loud of a voice. I've been their headline 7 times. That's right, give me your hand. And I'm back, baby, 2021. What does I look like? This is my river. You hear me, Shoreline? This is my river, yeah, right by me. Now, the North Branch of the river, y'all, this has been primarily industrial for a long time. And this wasn't until the early 2000s that we started to experience this sort of residential boom. Now, Kinsey Park, beautiful example of a private band community designed by George and Pat and George, two women who are in rural houses. Now, to give y'all an idea of how badly people wanted to live on the North Branch during that boom, each townhouse there ended up selling for about $1.2 million each. Before they even broke ground. Their biggest concern is the volume of my voice. What's that one? When you're up to our right, you're going to see the riverbank loss right here. Now, this was built in 1909 by George Nivens. This is the same architect as that asymmetrical warehouse building I just talked about. You already see the similarities in the brick masonry, right? Now, this was a form of printing facility.
It's here on the outside of the building. Home to a fitness center next to a donut shop. One might argue that's fairly American too. Put it on, take it off, rinse and repeat, baby. To your right, the black box I was talking about earlier. Now, Mies van der Rohe did not design these buildings. He just popularized the style back in the Bauhaus school in Germany, which was forced to close around World War II. Well, Mies van der Rohe picked up, came to Chicago. The ledge at the 103rd floor of the building. You can walk in a solid glass box and look down on 102 floors of air. You can see 4 different states from up there. Seriously, you can see Indiana, Wisconsin, Michigan. Anybody guess what the fourth state is? Illinois, good job. I had one guy that told me on a very clear day he saw Ohio.